This video is brought to you by Raycon. Hey folks, how's it going? Today we are talking about Adventure Time Obsidian. This is another entry into the Distant Land Archives. It's I'd call it more of an anthology series where we're revisiting the land of Ooo, but not on Cartoon Network through HBO Max. Because, ladies and gentlemen, we are in the middle of the streaming wars. But I'll talk about that here in a bit. So there will be a total of 4 mini-movies for Distant Lands. There's already been one called BMO. It came out, I think, about 4 months ago. I watched it. I liked it. I like Obsidian much better. Not that BMO was bad. It's just that Obsidian has a lot more going on with characters who I prefer. I don't really find BMO to be that interesting as a main character, more of a side character. Bubblegum, Marceline, however, I feel different about. So Adventure Time, for folks who don't know, ended about a year and a half ago. And Distant Lands was actually like thought up of before the show ended, but the idea was scrapped. Then HBO Max was like, hey, we're trying to launch the streaming site, we need more content, so make these movies. They're technically movies. And the movies themselves, the premise behind them being that we're going along with different characters from Adventure Time and catching stories about them, whether it be BMO in space, Marceline and Bubblegum post-finale of Adventure Time. It's interesting. I feel like the variety of when these episodes take place, where they take place, there's a lot of possibilities going on. And that's like half the excitement about Adventure Time Distant Lands. We don't know where or when these stories are going to turn up, which works really well with the Adventure Time setting. By the way, spoilers ahead, but I won't get too far into them, but enough to where they are spoilers. So the synopsis behind Obsidian, as I said, we're following Marceline and Bubblegum for this one. And for those who watched the finale for Adventure Time, we know for certainty that these two are a couple. A couple with a tumultuous, is that the right word? A rough past, with their ups and downs in history and what led them to this moment. And Obsidian is basically a way for us to look back in time and see some of the bad episodes that Bubblegum and Marceline had before now. It's kind of like some unresolved emotions and feelings and memories, and it all is summarized with this monster in this glass kingdom. Some lava creature who has been stored away in a mountain and now it's starting to break free. It's very obvious that this monster is symbolic of Marceline's emotions and how things have changed, but we'll get to that in a moment. One of the more interesting parts to me, though, was the background about Marceline's mom. Marceline, to me, is one of the most interesting characters from Adventure Time. Half human, half vampire, half demon. She's a big old mixture of all kinds of powers and creatures, and also one who survived the Mushroom Wars, aka humanity's nuclear holocaust, and how she and her mother are trying to survive the fallout. Spoilers, Marceline's mom doesn't survive. And that right there is a big part of our story. We see how Marceline, from a very young age, struggles with relationships. And that's a big part of our story. How Marceline suffered a lot from a very young age, with losing her mother, with not really understanding why things went down. She thought her mother ran away. No, her mother died. Her mother died alone, on purpose, away from Marceline to protect her. And all that emotional baggage Marceline's been carrying for thousands of years, or at least close to 1,000 years, I believe. Hundreds, at least. She didn't know the full story, and this entire time she's been assuming that her mother left because Marceline scared her, and that Marceline scares away other people, and that it's part of her personality to use that fear to protect herself, to act tough, to act mean, to put folks down because she's afraid of her own self. But we get to see her growth as a person, how she's in a better place now with Bubblegum, who also admittedly has a lot of history and baggage. But now we see how Marceline's able to open up, talking about her mom, what happened to her mom, talking about herself, opening up to Bubblegum, opening up to her own self. This is a story about emotional growth and coming to terms with things. That's the point of the monster. The monster was locked away. It's symbolic of Marceline's past and her and her unresolved emotions and how, like, back in the day when she put that monster in the volcano and trapped it, that was from a temper. It's like a Band-Aid. It's like she put a Band-Aid over a scar. Not even a scar, just a wound. But it wasn't healing. It was just a temporary solution. But now that she's back at the kingdom with Bubblegum, we're starting to address that past stuff and how it's like, we quote-unquote resolved it, but now it's time to truly address it and heal it and put it to rest. Also, it being a lava monster works well with the title of the series, Obsidian. I believe, if I'm correct here, because I Googled it, Obsidian is when lava cools rapidly, so maybe that's part of Marceline's story about her calming down and letting go and how she was really heated up in the past and then finally cooled off. And maybe that's the symbolic nature of the lava monster and Marceline and the title of this particular movie. Though I could be wrong. Also, Finn! Hey, there he is! He looks great. And I'm pretty sure that's one of Jake's granddaughters. Maybe we'll find out later in a future episode. But overall, great story. I really dig the building of relationships between Marceline, Bubblegum, seeing them talk about the monster represents their past relationship and how it was resolved and how Marceline can put that fear and pain and sorrow behind her and actually find peace with Bubblegum because they love each other. They've grown up and that's awesome. Also, we got some amazing songs, catchy songs in this movie. Love them. Marceline is a wonderful singer. And yeah, I love this movie. I enjoyed it. I'm a big fan of Marceline and Bubblegum. Funny enough, I tweeted about it. And by the way, for those who don't want to hear this stuff, whatever, I don't care. I'm going to talk about it. There are people who are like, oh, this was a forced relationship for LGBT reasons. I don't believe that. I understand the idea of pandering with those kinds of relationships, which is very interesting that we live in an era where that's on the table for discussion. I mean, I personally feel like Bubblegum and Marceline have been growing throughout like the past decade with the relationship, building their history, very well done, and nice slow burn to it. I like it. I'm a fan. Very well executed. Would not call it pandering by any means. But I'm a little bit surprised that a lot of folks on my Twitter were replying with that notion. And I'm just kind of like, I don't see it. I can see that argument maybe with other shows, but not here. Marceline and Bubblegum have a strong, well-written, structured relationship. But hey, maybe that's just my opinion. So yeah, those are my overall thoughts about Adventure Time Obsidian. I recommend it. It's on HBO Max. Tell me what you all think in the comments, and I'll see you all next time. So a big shout out to this video sponsor, Raycon Earbuds. I've been a patron of Raycon for over a year now, and I gotta say, they made me a big believer of wireless earbuds. I use them all the time, while doing chores around the house, working on videos, lifting weights, and real talk. It's nice not having a wire constantly getting tangled up in me all the time. I also appreciate how stylish they look, and they fit well in my ears too. They also come with earbud adjustments to get a fit that's perfect for you. There's also a recharging case that is very potent and can get your Raycon earbuds to full power four times over on a single charge. And best of all, Raycons aren't stupid expensive like other brands. They're actually fairly priced, but still have a high level of sound quality. I've been rocking their latest model for a while now, the Everyday E25s, and it's their best version yet. It has 6-hour playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, a rich bass to the sound, and a more compact design that gives you a nice noise-isolating fit. There are also new colors to pick from. Oh, and celebrities such as Snoop Dogg, Mike Tyson, and J.R. Smith are obsessed with Raycons. So, click the link in the description down below and use buyraycon.com/saberspark. to get 20% off your Raycon purchase. And now is the best time to get the best prices of the year on Raycons. But hurry, this offer is available for a limited time only.